Hi, I'm Stephen Cronin. Today I'm going to show you how you can improve your watercolours. But first, let's take a look at the palette and so you can paint along with me. So we have ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, raw sienna, burnt umber, light red. They're all listed in the video description. We've got my brush of choice is the large Ron Ranson Hake, and we've got 15 by 11 Fabriano, £130 cold pressed. So I'm going to start off with a big 8 brush, and this is just clear water all over the paper. This will stop it from crinkling and soften off some of the background. And I'm going to take a bit of raw sienna, lemon yellow. And this is like a sort of mass of foliage, green leaves. It'll start to take shape as the painting progresses. But this is just a sort of general sort of foresty colour. Bit of ultramarine in there, just to darken it up here and there. But the main point of this bit is to try and create not just a sort of mass of green leaves and whatnot, is this light. Just a sense of light that will come through as we progress through the painting. So a bit of blue there, just to darken it here and there. And then while that paper's still wet, I'm going to switch to the little brush. First, I'm just going to put a little bit of water on the palette, because it will need water, this little brush. And I'm just going to use the same colours, a bit of raw sienna, ultramarine, lemon yellow. A bit of burnt umber in there as well, I think. And then these are the most distant trees poking through the sort of foreground foliage. Now the horizon line, it's actually quite a high one really. Maybe up there somewhere. So I'm just going to reflect down from there. More water, a bit of brown, a bit of blue, a bit of yellow. Again, as I put them on, I'm just pulling down the reflections while I've got the colour on the brush. A few more on the left hand side. I'll bang them reflections in. They have to be bang on, as long as it's there or thereabouts, you'll get away with it. Just going to suggest a few little twigs and branches coming off. So that's like the sort of first layer. And what I might do before I put up, I'm just going to let that dry slightly. And I'm going to clean the brush, take the excess water off on the tea towel. I'm going to take just a tiny bit of raw sienna, lemon yellow, and just work out where the land is. So quite a high horizon line. It's going to go up there somewhere like that. It's going to come down there, and it's going to be all water down the bottom. It's up there, something like that. Water's going to sort of snake around and come out somewhere in this foreground. Right. And before the paper dries completely, I just want to pop in some more. Now you see the paper, because it's dry, now it's going on stronger. Reflections. Down there, put those reflections in, a bit more paint and water on the brush, and a few more trees on this side, put those reflections in. Now we do need a few branches and twigs on there, so I'm just going to pop those in now. Don't forget to reflect down below what you've just done above. It doesn't have to be exact, as long as it's roughly there, it'll just make the water look a bit more realistic. Pop those through all the way along, a few more reflections down there. A strong one in across there. We're going to be in a little bit darker. I did forget to put the reflection on. Right, now the paper has stretched a little bit, so I'm just going to pull it tight to get it flat against the board again. It's a 9mm piece of plywood I use on this easel, almost 90 degrees, but that's only to help me film it. You don't have to have it that high if you don't want to. Now for the final few trees, I'm doing a bit of brown, a bit of blue. Maybe just dip it into the raw sienna as well. Now these are the strongest ones, right in the foreground. Well, not in the foreground, but closer than the others. Don't forget the reflections. About the same. Reload the brush. Bit of brown, bit of blue, dark colour. And then I'll just push it into the raw sienna. Again. Pipe in the reflection down there. I've done those three in a line, so I want to try them in a different direction now. They're looking a bit too artificial. Some are going the other way. Yeah, a little thin one in there. I'm going that way. Pop a few branches on those, so plenty of water, switch the little brush, brown, blue, dark colour. Don't forget to pop the reflections in. Up there. Put those reflections in while I've got the paint on the brush. A few little twigs and branches. Reflections down below. And then what I'll do afterwards, I'll just put some more on the left hand side first, but then I'll add a bit of foliage, a bit of green in there. Now these are slightly further back, these trees. Just at the corner of the brush, and just to bring the hairs back together, just so I've got this nice chisel edged hike. Again. Slightly further away, so I'm just doing these a bit thinner. Just get that chisel edge again. On this left hand side, a bit thicker there, I think. then switch back to the little brush, and there's a few twigs and branches here and there, a few reflections down below. Right, now I'm going to clean the brush and squeeze all the water out of it, tip the rest out on the tea towel. So it's pretty dry, and then start with a bit of lemon yellow, a few nice dollops on there, and start off in there, save the light bit. Don't forget the reflections down below, pop those in. And add a bit of ultramarine to darken that yellow up a bit. And pop the reflections in below. A bit of raw sienna as well in there. So I'm going to clean the brush now. I want to try and get back to a sort of cleaner green colour. Again, back through the progress, squeeze the water out into the jar, scuff it up on the tea towel. And get back into that lemon yellow. Right, let's just define where the water meets the land. So I just want to get a little bit darker. Just dip the tips into the water just to bring the hairs back together. That's a bit too wet. So I'm just going to, rather than clean it all again, I'm just going to dry it on a piece of tissue. It doesn't matter if you get it dirty. Again, a bit of burnt umber, a bit of ultramarine, and a bit of raw sienna in there. Now I'm just working out where this land lies now. This is the sort of banks of the river now, this is. And then what I might do, just scrape a few rocks in here and there. Dark, so I can scrape something. I've got to scrape out. I don't want to put it completely parallel with that side. I'm just getting somewhat like that. Rocks in. And then what I'm going to do next, again I'm just going to clean the brush, squeeze that water out. And I just want it fairly dry, just clean damp brush with a nice edge on it. I'm just going to tip those sides down, just sort of blend them in slightly. All I'm doing, I'm just dabbing with a clean damp brush. brighten it up a bit. Cutting straight across those reflections. This just looks like little ripples on the water. A bit on this side. Just straighten that brush out again. And again, see, just like the little ripples on the water. Also just cutting across those reflections. I'm just going to pop those in all the way down to the bottom. Right, now someone else. Next thing I'm going to do, some shadows. So we've got our light source there. So I'm just going to take a bit of brown, a bit of red, a bit of blue. Like a shadowy colour. Right, so imagine, say the light's there. I'm just going to follow that line, just follow that shadow in there. That's that tree. Across there. There's shadows off these trees coming down. Darken that a little bit. And the shadow there. Something from behind. Just do a few shadows on the other side. There's a few more on this side, so put that across. There's the first one. Down there alongside that one, I'm just going to darken those, I think more shadowy on this side of the trunk, and down somewhere else, and down there. Darken those, shadow comes down there. More shadows along there. Darken those a little bit. More shadows coming across. Not nothing, just darken this a little bit more. More shadows in there. So all this needs to be a little bit darker. Just take out a bit more. I'm trying to be careful not to sort of paint over everything I've just done. So I think what it needs is a few more rocks and something in the foreground. So let's just bash some at the end down there. I think just some down there. Come down there a little bit more. Just strengthen these rocks a little bit. Down a bit more. And just try to hold a load of rocks and some big ones down there. Big one there.
down there.
I think we need something down here as well. Because the horizon line's so high up. I just need to make it just a little bit darker in there. So I'm just taking a lemon yellow, a bit of pine dry. Let's just try and darken it a little bit more. Darken this area a little bit more, it's a real sort of shadowy area around there. Just trying to balance those tones just to get it to look right. Always break it up a little bit. Imagine like the light sort of just coming through and just catching the odd little rock here and there. Well, I'll pause there for a sec, just have a look in the back of the room, and I don't think there's much now I can do to improve it, to be honest with you. All I'm going to do, I'm just going to stick my name down in the corner and call this one finished. Let's stick a mate on it and see what it looks like. So here we have our painting all mounted up, so if we go and have a closer look at it. First thing I did after wetting the paper, I just brushed in this sort of green, light green colour all over, just to give it that sort of foliage feel, sort of foliage en masse. Then putting the trees in three layers, first the most distant ones using the rigger brush, very far away like that one and these here, you can just about see in the distance, all the way across. And then not forgetting to put the reflections in the water below. Then when the paper's a little bit drier, put them in so you get them a little bit stronger. Pushes those ones, the initial ones, further back. Again, don't forget the reflections down below in the water section. And then the third lot of trees, put in using really thick paint. More paint, less water, but good strong thick paint mix. And then these push those other two layers further back even more, and again, put the reflections in the water to help make the water look a bit realistic. And then taking this sort of central light area, casting its shadows through the trees there. You see, just following the line, casting the shadows on the floor, and then just scraping out the rocks. And you can see, just looks like the light's catching the left-hand side of the rocks, and then the right-hand side's in darkness. And again, just try to darken this foliage area, again just trying to heighten the contrast between light and dark. Same on this side, got the light coming along here, casting these shadows, and again just sort of big sort of shadowy area here. Bit of dry brush work here, just to create a few leaves, started off with a sort of light yellow, and then added a bit of ultramarine and Payne's Grey to make them darker. Just like these ones up in this corner. That's it for today then. Don't forget to subscribe, leave your comments down below. Thanks for watching, keep practicing, and I'll see you again soon.